What's up, guys? In this episode, we're going to talk about boost leak testing. But first, be sure to subscribe. And if you want to support the channel, check out our Patreon page. All right. If you have a turbo car, you may have seen someone mention boost leak testing. When you have a boost leak, pressure is being relieved under boost, which means your turbo has to work harder to achieve the desired PSI. Boost leaks can be caused by any number of issues, such as loose connections, cracked vacuum lines, bad gaskets, cracked or broken hoses or an intercooler, and so on. So how do you know if you have a boost leak? Well, you do a boost leak test. Just because you're expecting 20 PSI and your gauge reads 20 PSI doesn't mean that you don't have a boost leak. Now, depending on the severity of the leak, your turbo can usually compensate so everything will appear to be normal according to your gauge. Now, boost leaks will impact performance even if you're hitting the desired boost. Boost leak testing is the only way to ensure that your system is sealed. It's also a good way to test your wastegate actuator for proper operation and to test vacuum lines and other components to make sure that they aren't going to blow off while driving under boost. It's a good idea to do a boost leak test whenever you've done any work on the turbo, post-turbo intake, or vacuum lines. Doing a boost leak test is pretty simple. You just need an air compressor and a boost leak adapter like this one. It's a pretty simple device. It's simply a silicone coupler that's open on one end and has a valve stem on the other. Now, some adapters might have a different connector. Instead of a valve stem, it could be a direct connection for an air hose, but essentially they all do the same thing in the same way. The open end goes on your turbo inlet and the other end gets a source of air. Now, these come in different sizes, so you need to make sure you get the right size for your turbo inlet. Now, the important part of this is your air compressor. You cannot use the 100 PSI tire pumps that you get at Harbor Freight. Not only do they not have enough output, they have to be running all the time because they don't have a tank, which means you won't be able to hear any leaks. Now, some people claim that they use a bicycle pump, but I've yet to see it happen. You're going to have some bleed off, so it's best to have an air compressor with a tank and an adjustable regulator. If you don't have one, I highly recommend that you get one, or at least find a friend who has one because, well, you can't do the test without one. Now, before you start, there are some places that may need to be plugged up. The most common is the vent side of the valve cover, which normally has a hose going to the intake. Just plug it using a bolt at the end of the hose or find some other way to close it up. And when you start the test, you may find other places that need to be plugged up. This is fine, just plug them up. What you're really concerned about are the vacuum lines and all the connections and hoses, hard pipes, between your turbo output and your throttle body. So once everything's plugged up, connect the air hose to your boost leak tester, make sure the tester is connected to your turbo inlet, adjust the regulator on your compressor and set it to about 5 PSI higher than what your target boost level is. For example, if you're supposed to see 20 pounds of boost, set the regulator to 25 PSI. Then just listen for any leaks. I recommend that you wiggle the hoses and hard pipes to be sure that they aren't leaking when they move. I've had this happen a few times and it's really an annoying problem to track down. If you hear a leak and you can't find exactly where it is, you can use a spray bottle with regular water and watch for any noticeable spray. If that doesn't work, you can also try soapy water and then watch for bubbles. Now, it's normal for the system to not stay pressurized. As I said, there will be some bleed off, so don't worry about it unless it's really bad. Fix any leaks that you find, and you're good to go. If tightening the hose clamps doesn't work, reseat the hoses and adjust the clamps as needed. If your vacuum lines are blowing off, you can use zip ties or get some small clamps to keep them on. All right, that's it for this episode. Be sure to subscribe, and if you like this video, click that like button or leave a comment below. Thanks for watching.